Good afternoon, all of you. Respected Mansi ma'am, joint CEO of Scope, and all the participants, those who have joined us in the Harmony Poetry Recitation competition organized by Scope. Now, I would like to request and invite Mansi ma'am to say a few words on this Harmony Poetry Recitation competition. Mansi ma'am is the joint CEO of Scope, and she's going to share a few words on this Harmony Poetry Recitation competition. Ma'am, I request you to say a few words.
Thank you, Dipti. Good afternoon, friends. I welcome you all to our poetry recitation competition, Harmony Poetry Competition, arranged by Scope. Scope is a society which is working under higher education, Government of Gujarat. It runs various programs. As you know, we are conducting quizzes, competitions. We are having the Cambridge as our partner, as our exam agent. We are conducting various exams like CPT and Lingua Skill. After appearing in the examination, you can have Cambridge certification, which is very much valuable. As you know, poetry is a form of expression. Today we are here to listen to various poems, right? It is a form of literature, which is an expression of thoughts and feelings. In a nutshell, poetry can have a positive impact on the social and emotional being. We know various English poets such as Wordsworth, Keats, Coleridge, and in Gujarati we have Kavi Narmad, Zarachand Meghani, Sundaram. Various poets are there who have given the words to their feelings and thoughts. So poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings, which gives an impact on our mind for a long time. So let us start today's Harmony Poetry Harmony competition, and I welcome you all on behalf of Scope. Dipti is our Scope team member, and she is working hard on this project, and she will elaborate various criteria which you have to follow in this competition. Over to Dipti. Thank you.
Thank you, Mansi ma'am, to share the things that what is the importance of poetry in our life. We can learn so many things for a long term from this poetry, and we can share our expression, our thoughts, and our understanding. And based on this explanation, we can understand a lot of things from this poetry. So Gujarati ma je ma'am e kahyu ke ghana bada poet thai gaya chhe, ghana loko e ghani evi apanne shikhavan je ghani badi shikh aapi chhe ke je apne poetry thi apne learn kari shakiye chhe, ane long term apni life ma, ane as a moral ane as an understanding, as a learning, we can imbibe in our life, in our, and that thing we can inculcate in our life, that we can never be forgot these things. So we remember throughout our life, and we learn so many things from poetry. So now we are going to start the poetry recitation competition. Before starting this competition, I would like to share a few rules and regulation regarding this competition. For this competition, in this competition, as we have already shared the rules and regulations, that you need to select a topic from patriotic, nature, mother, your greatest fear, or a dream. So out of this topic, you need to select one topic. You all are aware of these things. Then the time limit for this poetry, it is minimum 2 minutes and maximum 4 minutes. So what you are supposed to do, that you start with your name, then from where you belong, then your topic of the poem, name of the poem, author name, and then you start with your recitation. Again, I would like to share it in Gujarati. So pratham tamare tamaru naam ahiya announce karvanu chhe, tame kyathi belong karo chho. For example, I am Dipti Garvi and I am from Ahmedabad. To tamare evi rite kehvanu chhe ke I am so and so name, and I belong from this and this city, right? Then देन તમારો ટોપિક નું નામ કે તમે પેટ્રિયોટિક સિલેક્ટ કરી છે, નેચર સિલેક્ટ કર્યું છે, મધર સિલેક્ટ કર્યું છે. આફ્ટર ધેટ તમારા પોએમ નું નામ, આફ્ટર ધેટ તમારા ઓથર નું નામ, એન્ડ ધેન ધ રેસિટેશન ઓર ધ એક્સપ્લેનેશન. નાઉ જ્યારે તમારું રેસિટેશન સ્ટાર્ટ થાય ત્યાંથી અમે લોકો અહીંથી ટાઈમ કાઉન્ટ કરીશું, એન્ડ એઝ એન વેન 4 મિનિટ્સ જેવી ઓવર થશે અહીંયાથી અમે તમને સ્ટોપ કરીશું. સો આફ્ટર ધેટ યુ આર નોટ અલાઉડ ટુ સ્પીક. સો ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી મચ ક્લિયર દેટ ઇન અ નટશેલ હાઉ કેન હાઉ આર યુ એબલ ટુ થ્રો ધી આઈડિયાઝ વેલ. સો દેટ ઇઝ ધી મેઇન ઓબ્જેક્ટિવ. નાઉ વિલ કમ ટુ ધ ઇવેલ્યુએશન ક્રાઇટેરિયા દેટ ઇઝ બેઝડ ઓન યોર ક્લેરિટી. ક્લેરિટી ના તમારે અહીંયા 20 માર્ક્સ છે. એવું નહીં કે તમે અહીંયા આવીને પોએમ જસ્ટ રીડ કરીને જતા રહ્યા, દેન યુ આર નોટ એલિજિબલ ટુ ગેટ ધી માર્ક્સ. સો દેર આર ફ્યુ ક્રાઇટેરિયા ફોર ધ ઇવેલ્યુએશન ઇન વિચ ધ ફર્સ્ટ વન ઇઝ ધી ક્લેરિટી. ક્લેરિટી ના 20 માર્ક્સ છે. આફ્ટર દેટ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડિંગ બેઝ ઓન યોર એક્સપ્લેનેશન એના 20 માર્ક્સ છે. દેન કોન્ફિડન્સ, યુ નીડ ટુ શેર યોર પોએટ્રી વિથ ધી કોન્ફિડન્સ. So confidence is carrying 20 marks. Then articulation, your voice modulation, the way you are expressing the poetry. So articulation are 20 marks. And ultimately, last but not the least, that is your overall presentation. Overall presentation, based on that will give you 20 marks. All the total comes to the 100. So now I will speak up the name of the participants, and that participants need to unmute himself or herself and start his or her video. એમણે એમનો પોતાનો વિડિયો સ્ટાર્ટ કરવાનો છે અને એમણે પોતાની જાતને અનમ્યુટ કરવાના છે, બાકી બધા પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ મ્યુટ રહેશે. સો ધ ફર્સ્ટ વન ઇઝ રૂપસાર પઠાણ. I request Rukhsar Pathan to start her poem. When you have, like, if you are having some technical issue and if you are not able to switch on your camera or video, it is fine. But you need to speak with your expression, with your thoughts, yes, and with your clear cut understanding, right? So yes, okay. I request Rukhsar Pathan to start your poem.
Okay. My name is Rukhsar Pathan. I belong to Rajkot. I am studying in MVM Arts College, Rajkot, from Saurashtra University. Today, I am going to recite the poem, Wordsworth's poem, My Heart Leaps Up. And the author is William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth is an English poet. He is the founder of English Romanticism. He is remembered as a poet concerned with human relationship to nature. His most of the poetries are related to love of nature. So ma'am, can I start my recitation now?
Yes.
I'm going to start my recitation. My heart leaps up when I behold a rainbow in the sky. So was it when my life began, so is it now I am a man. So be it when I shall grow old or let me die. This is the first stanza of the poem. In this stanza, the Wordsworth or the speaker is telling us that whenever he holds the view of rainbow, his heart skips a beat and he feels spontaneous joy and happiness by seeing the rainbow. He moves ahead and tells that he has seen the rainbow when his life begins. It means he has seen the rainbow and this beautiful a view in his childhood, and when he is grown up in his current life, when he is now a grown man right now, and he wants to, and he wishes to see the rainbow and this pleasurable view, and whenever he grow old, or if he will not be able to see this pleasurable view, he wants to die. It means he says that he wants to die if he will not be able to see the rainbow and admire it. The poet moves ahead and the second stanza starts. The child is father of the man, and I could wish my days to be bound each to each by natural piety. The speaker says that the child is the father of the man. It means the childhood bounds and creates a man's whole attitude and his personality. And the speaker says that he wished that he is his rest of the life will be surrounded by admiration and devotion to natural piety. Natural's devotion. He says that he wants that his rest of the life will be surrounded by devotion to nature. Thank you so much for the listening to me.
Thank you, Rukhsar. You have spoken it for 2 minutes, thanks for it's a wonderful poem which you have recited. Now I would request Chandini Bora. Is she there? Next is Vinay Sheth.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Vinay Sheth, a final year student of BE Computer Engineering at Vishwakarma Government Engineering College, Ahmedabad. Today, I have got the golden opportunity to recite the nature-themed poem, The Daffodils, written by William Wordsworth as a part of the Harmony Poetry Recitation Competition organized by SCOPE. Before starting, I would like to give you all a brief introduction of the poet. William Wordsworth was born on 7th April 1770 at Cockermouth. His father, John Wordsworth, was an attorney to Lord Lonsdale and was an influential man of his time. His mother, Annie Cookson, was the only daughter of William Cookson, a well-to-do dealer in milk products at Penrith. He was educated at Hawkshead Grammar School and St. John College, Cambridge, from where he did his BA in 1791. The relation between nature and man became the main theme of his poetry. His major literary works include The Lyrical Ballads, The Solitary Reaper, Guide to the Lakes, To the Cuckoo, The Prelude, and many more. Now I would like to recite the poem, The Daffodils, which is based on the theme of the healing and refreshing power of nature. The Daffodils. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretched in a never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. For oft, when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. Now I would like to explain the poem. The poem depicts how easy it is for nature to lift the spirit and the morale of the humans. The poet starts the poem by comparing himself with a cloud, wandering lonely here and there. But as soon as he sees the beautiful golden daffodils dancing and fluttering with the light breeze, he finds himself captivated by their magical beauty. The poet says that whenever he lies in a state of solitude, the images of the daffodils flash upon his imagination. When this happens, the poet feels calm, refreshed, motivated, and mesmerized. The memories of the daffodils fill his heart with pleasure and joy, and he feels like dancing along with them. This is how the nature influences him. The poem clearly highlights the healing and refreshing effect of the nature on the poet. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vinay. You shared it very wonderfully, and your explanation also very nicely. You shared the author details, and after that, the poem also very good expression. And after that, the explanation of the poem also, it is a very nicely you explained, wonderfully explained by Vinay. Then Twara Ojas.
Good afternoon, respected judges and everyone present here. Myself, Twara Mangad from Rajkot, and I am a student of 11th standard in Dholakia School, Rajkot. Today, I have selected a nature-based poem which is penned down by John Keats and is titled A Thing of Beauty. John Keats is a British romantic poet who was trained to be a surgeon but devoted himself completely to writing poetry. And the following poem which I'm going to recite, that is A Thing of Beauty, is an excerpt from one of the Greek legends which is written by John Keats, that is Endymion, a poetic romance. Endymion revolves around the story of a young shepherd who dreams of the moon goddess Cynthia and then wanders searching for her in the forest, in the seas, under the water and everywhere. So the gist of the poem lies in the fact that we human beings are so much busy in our materialistic life that we often tend to ignore the calm and the beautiful scenery of the nature, which is often playing a vital role in our life. And the best part is that the beauty is not momentary or for a short period of time. It is constant, it is continuous, and that is what makes it the best part in John Keats' writing. Also, the ability of John Keats to sway and delight the readers with his distinctive style of writing is what makes this poem a more adorable one. So now I would like to start with the recitation of my poem, A Thing of Beauty. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases and will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth of noble natures, of the gloomy days, and of all the unhealthy and o'er-darkened ways made for our searching. Yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty takes away the pall from our dark spirits. Such is the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep. Such are the daffodils with the green world they live in and the clear rills. For themselves that a cooling cover they make against the hot season, the mid-forest break. And such too is the grandeur of the dooms, rich in a fair musk rose blooms. And we have imagined for the mighty dead all the lovely tales we heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tuvara. You have beautifully explained the nature, and it is very true that in this materialistic life, we need to be so calm and we need to feel the nature. And as we seen in this current scenario, that every day people are running like every day to get something, to achieve their goals and objective in their life. And meanwhile, in this materialistic life, they forget about the nature, they forget about the environment, they forget about everything and they just want to reach their goal. So apart from all this, they also need to feel the beautiful nature that's given by the God. We need to feel that nature, we need to be calm. So it is beautifully explained by you. Tuvara, thank you so much. Now, next is Priyanka Kumari Jala.
So, namaste and very good afternoon to everyone present over here. Myself, Priyanka Kumari Zala from Christ College, Rajkot. I am pursuing my graduation, BA English, and third year. So the topic I have selected for my recitation is nature, under which I have selected one of the famous poems by Robert Frost, that is Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening. It was published in 1923. And Robert Frost is an American poet, and most of the poems are nature-based theme. His poems deal with nature as a major theme, and his works were initially published in England and later on in US. So now I start my poem, Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. Whose woods these are? I think I know. His house is in the village, though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop here without a farmhouse near, between the woods and a snow and a frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his harness's bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep So now I'll explain what the poem means. So in the poem, the narrator is a traveler with a horse, and he is stopping by woods and to wander and to see around the woods filling up with snow and enjoy the beauty. But his horse asks with harnesses bells shake, so that if there is any problem or if this place is familiar to him. The poet in initial stanza says that he knows whose woods these are. So, and here the person whose woods that are is living in the village, and he'll not be here to appreciate this beauty, wonderful beauty. And later on, he goes on to say that his horse asks his if there is some mistake and if he has stopped by mistake over that place. In that woods where nothing is there, and the evening is also very dark, darkest time of that winter. And in last stanza, which is very beautiful and which I like the most, is the woods are lovely. He's appreciating the beauty around, and he says that he expresses his wish to stay there, but he also says that I cannot stay, but I have promises to keep. But he also does not reveal whose promises he have to keep. And the last two lines are repetition, and miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep. That means he's emphasizing on the point that he wants to stay, but he cannot. And he have to travel, and before he sleeps, that is before he dies, he have to travel. And this is wonderful poem. This I had studied in 11-12. And
our time is over now. Okay. Thank you so much. You have explained very nicely, beautifully. You have explained it, and wonderful poem you have selected. Thank you so much. Next is Swasti, you can start your poem.
This is Swasti Jha. I am from Surat, Sri Ramakrishna College, first year ES batch. Today the topic of my poem is Gift of India, and I have selected the topic that is based on patriotism. The poem which I have selected is written by Sarojini Naidu. As we all know that Sarojini Naidu is the Nightingale of India, and her views on any related topic on freedom or anything is really marvelous. She has really appreciated all, we really appreciate all our efforts towards all the harmony and peace of our country. So before starting my topic, I would like to thank you to the team of Scope who gave me opportunity to speak or share my views on any poem and topics related to it. So now here I am reciting my poem, The Gift of India. Is there aught you need that my hands withhold? Rich gifts of raiment or grain or gold? Lo, I have flung to the east and west priceless treasures torn from my breast, and yielded the sons of my stricken womb to the drum beats of beauty, the shabres of doom. Gathered like pearls in their ellen graves, silenced they sleepy by the Persian waves. Scattered like shells of Egyptian sand, they lie with pale brows and brave broken hands. They are strewn like blossoms, mourned on by chance, on the blooded brown meadows of Flanders and France. Can we measure the grief of the tears I weep, or compass the woe of the watch I keep, or the pride that thrills through my heart's despair, and the hope that comforts the anguish of prayer? And the far, sad, glorious vision I see of the torn red banners of victory, when the terror and tumult of hate shall cease, and life be refreshable on anvils of peace, and your love shall offer memorial thanks to the compadres who fought in your dauntless ranks, and your honor the deeds of the deathless ones, remember the blood of my martyred sons. Now here I am explaining the meaning of the poem and the stanzas, where Sarojini Naidu has beautifully described the life of all the martyrs who sacrificed their life for our freedom, and had beautifully described about how they lived their life and how they got martyred, and even without complaining, they had fight for our freedom, fight for our peace. And she also had thanked all the mothers who gave birth to this brave child, and those who fearlessly sent their sons to fight for our freedom. And they had beautifully described how their wife and their families are also sacrificing their husband or father for just for our peace and for our freedom. She has beautifully written in the last stanza that all those terrors which we hate and which we will never think of going there, there all the martyrs are fighting for us, for just our freedom, so that we can lead our life peacefully and betterly. And at the end, she is saying that we cannot even measure the range of the tears which those mothers are facing, sending their sons to the for fighting, and those sons which they know that they might never return, but keeping this beautiful smile on their face, they are sending their sons for us, for our country. So at the end, she had thanked all the martyrs, and she had beautifully described this poem. So here I'm concluding my poem, and I'd like to say thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Swati. Beautifully explained this poem. Here I would like to thankful to all of you, those who have joined with us. Thank you so much to join with us, and thank you, Mansi ma'am, joint CEO of Scope, to join with us in this event. Yeah.
Thank you very much, all the participants. I like your ideas on poems. You all did very well. In future also, we are going to conduct various programs. Please do join us, join Scope. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mansi ma'am. Be with us and give inspiration to the participants and the youth of Gujarat to recite the poem and to learn the English. Thank you very much.